Hey guys, just here to do a little quick review on Smith & Wesson 500. I've had this for about a year now, and I think I've fired a little bit over 1,000 rounds through it. It gets quite expensive, but it's a lot of it's quite a bit, you know. It's a lot of fun to shoot. It's a 4-inch barrel, ported, 5-shot revolver. I mean, this gun's built like a tank. I don't know if you've probably seen some videos on YouTube on the recoil and, you know, how powerful the gun is. And, you know, it's no joke. I bought this new for about $925 out the door. And right now, you can probably get them between, I think, $800 to $875 used, and I think they're up to $1,000 now. And again, this is the model 500. They make a 460, which I'm thinking about buying one, just because the ammo is a little bit cheaper, and you have an option of loading, you know, 45 long Colts out of there. So, you know, you have different type of ammo options. Whereas this, it only accepts the 500 round, and right now they're getting to be pretty expensive. The cheapest box of 20 that I found was on a website called Cheaper Than Dirt, and it's a low recoil round. Forget who makes it. It's a pretty big brand name company though, and they're selling them for, I think, $47 for a box of 20, which is still quite expensive. And you know, I've shot hollow points out of here. You know, they make rounds for them from 300 grain all the way up to 700 grain, and the 700 grain I've shot out of here, which is not recommended for a 4-inch barrel. And that's a little bit too much for, you know, that's a little bit too much. I think it punishes the gun quite a bit if you're shooting a 700 grain out here. So I stick around with the 400 to 425, and the recoil really isn't that bad, not as bad as it looks on YouTube, but it's a lot of fun to shoot, and for me, I bought it for, main reason I bought it for was a fishing trip. And it wasn't a regular fishing trip. It was a fishing trip up in Alaska. And it's well known to have, you know, a big population of brown bear and also grizzly bear. And I bought it just for that. But I ended up finding that I was taking it to the range quite a bit. And it's, you know, it's a fun gun to shoot, and it gets some used to if you're not used to shooting big bored handguns. I have a Desert Eagle in the 50 AE, which is a handful there, but I mean this is a little bit more recoil than a Desert Eagle. If you're, you know, 400 450 grain, it's quite a bit more recoil than the Desert Eagle. The accuracy, I guess if you practice with it a little bit more, you know, it's not uncommon to, you know, at 50 yards to nail something. I think the longer barrel version, you'll probably be a lot more accurate. This, I've shot, you know, 8-inch bullseyes from 35 yards, I think, pretty accurately. And the only problem I have, it's adjustable sights in the rear. And what happened was, now this is the only problem I ever had with it, was the only problem was, I guess it's from the recoil of the gun itself, but I don't know if you can see it, but on the rear of this sight, there's a little clip that holds this in. And due to recoil, it actually flew out. Let me show you that screw. there's a screw right here that holds this little spring, like a little clip underneath the rear sight, and it actually sheared, and called Smith & Wesson up, and it was no problem. They actually sent me one, a replacement, and it actually sent me three clips replacements for these. And I don't know how common it is. I don't know if anybody else has experienced that, but I've put probably 200 rounds through it since then, and it's still holding zero. No problems with it so far. It's quite a big gun. You know, it's not something you're gonna conceal carry, or even when on my fishing trip, I had it in a holster, and it was you know, cumbersome, and I could feel it all day long there. Just something I wouldn't carry, you know, on a normal basis. You know, on our fishing trip, we might have stayed out, you know, 6 hours a day. You know, we had to hike out to where we fished and spend a couple hours out there. But on our hike back, you know, I could really start feeling it. But, you know, the weight doesn't really matter, because I felt a little bit more secure with it, you know, being out there. You know, with anything that's bigger than you are, this will, you know, if it doesn't kill him, it's going to hurt him pretty bad, you know. As you can see the porting there, that helps a lot. That actually helps reduce the recoil. I've shot the same size barrel, unported. Actually, I think it was a 2-inch barrel, unported. And that would break your wrist pretty, I mean, that gives a pretty good recoil. But with this muzzle brake, it actually reduces the recoil quite a bit. And so far, you know, I can't shoot all day with this, you know, especially if you're going, you know, 400 grain. You know, most I'd want to put through it and shoot it accurately would be maybe 120 rounds. Usually in a day that I would shoot this, and again, it's pretty expensive too. You know, prices are going up every day on it. Again, it's a revolver, built really solid. Everything's smooth on it. Actually, has a detent ball there, and that's just an extra security to hold the cylinder in, because again, there's a lot of pressure that's going through there, but. And it's unloaded. You can tell how much use I get out of this. I don't know if you can see the marks, but those won't come off. Those are just, I don't know if they're just burnt into the cylinder or what, but I've brushed them and cleaned them as good as I can. I still can't get those off. But again, I get a lot of use out of this. And again, I've put over 1,000 rounds through it. And the only malfunction I've had was with the rear sights. But overall, I mean, it's pretty nice gun. The grip is real, real comfortable. And I actually have a Ruger 44 Magnum, and